This is the second video in a series about installing the Early Warning Intervention and Monitoring System process, known as EWIMS. The video series is a collaborative effort by the Great Lakes Comprehensive Center and the Michigan Department of Education, and is based on the work of the National High School Center. There is a video for each of the 7 steps in the EWIMS process. All of the videos parallel the Michigan EWIMS Implementation Guide. Feel free to stop this video at any point and discuss the topics addressed. It is also recommended that you refer to the implementation guide for more information. The main objective of this video is to provide you with a clear understanding of Step 1 in the 7-step EWIMS process. Let's get started. As a refresher, EWIMS is a 7-step, data-driven, decision-making process that helps educators identify, match, and monitor students who show symptoms of risk for dropping out of high school. In EWIMS, educators systematically identify students in need of support. Early warning systems experts at American Institutes for Research, AIR, developed EWIMS tools and guidance by drawing on Bernhardt's research on data-based decision-making. AIR has conducted research on EWIMS. A rigorous impact study released in early 2017 found that EWIMS is a promising evidence-based strategy for getting students back on track for graduation. In the study, 73 schools were randomly assigned to either use or not use EWIMS during the 2014-2015 school year. After 1 year of implementation, schools using EWIMS had reduced the percentages of students with chronic absences and course failure. To access the study and for more information about EWIMS implementation and impact, please see the references at the end of this video. Step 1 is to establish roles and responsibilities. To assemble an EWIMS team, you need to figure out what will work best for your school and district. For installation, initial implementation, you'll want to consider these 3 issues: gathering the right people, meeting at the right frequency, and meeting for the right duration. Ask yourself these questions: who should be at the table? How regularly should we meet? And how much time should we meet for? Keep in mind that the main responsibility of the EWIMS team is to engage in data review, interpretation, and action. The purpose of the team is to decrease red flags or indicators that students are at risk for dropping out of school. Depending on your school's constraints, you may choose to integrate the EWIMS process into the work of an existing team rather than create a new team. Let's talk about the team that will meet regularly to review the early warning indicator data. The role of the team is to meet regularly to identify students based on the early warning system indicators of attendance, behavior, and course performance. Using this information, the team assigns interventions and monitors progress. This includes communicating beyond the team with others engaged in the interventions and soliciting feedback from stakeholders. Let's look at what we mean by getting the right people at the table. There are a few universal qualifications for EWIMS team members. Team members should have the following: the authority to make decisions. This is important because they will need to communicate next steps that require action. The expertise to manage and analyze data, including strict adherence to data privacy. Diverse knowledge of students, interventions, and resources. The best team members know the students personally and have an understanding of the school and the community. Clearly, assembling a strong EWIMS team can't be accomplished by simply bringing together staff who participate on committees because they're willing to stay after school. For initial implementation, you may need to schedule time for the EWIMS team to receive training on the EWIMS process and data capabilities. In most school districts, there are already teams in place that review data and/or assign interventions. EWIMS teams look different in different contexts. For example, it is fine to establish a new team to carry out the EWIMS process, but it can be just as effective to make the EWIMS process part of the charge of an existing team, as long as the team is given appropriate training and support. There are schools that embed EWIMS into an existing student study team, a multi-tiered systems of support team, or a school improvement team. Some schools have a large EWIMS team that examines school trends and needs, while a smaller team analyzes individual student needs. Some schools have different EWIMS teams for different grade levels or student cohorts. Here are some suggestions for the broad representation you will need for your EWIMS team. Note that district office representatives do not participate in the team for oversight or compliance purposes. These staff are present to provide support to the team, such as communicating the importance of EWIMS throughout the district and arranging professional development opportunities for the team. When recruiting members for the team, be sure to explain that the team itself does not implement all of the relevant interventions. Team members help to identify those who are able to lead interventions and verify whether the interventions are implemented with fidelity. Occasionally, they implement interventions, but not always. Once you have identified members who have agreed to be on the EWIMS team, you'll need to determine roles for team members. The following roles are critical: the team lead, the data lead, and the meeting facilitator. We will discuss the optional rotating roles shortly. An agenda for each meeting should be prepared at the end of the previous meeting. Some items should be addressed at each team meeting, such as reviewing data from the tool, actions taken for individual students and groups of students, ongoing and completed action items from the previous meeting, new action items, and communication with staff and leadership. Notes, which should be taken at each meeting, should include the action items identified and individuals responsible for each action. Finally, the agendas and notes should be kept on file to provide a record of the team's work. How often should the EWIMS team meet? We recommend meeting at the following critical time periods. First, be sure to meet before the new school year begins. Then, meet at the start of the school year to focus on students who ended the previous year with indicators of risk, as well as students who are new to the school, including the freshman class. Meet again after the first 20 to 30 days of the school year to address students who are falling behind or failing to attend school. These students will have a hard time catching up later. Meetings should be held regularly throughout the school year, a minimum of once after each grading period. Meet frequently enough to give the team time to discuss issues as they arise and to monitor student progress. And be sure to meet at the end of the school year to discuss how to improve student supports and the overall operation of the EWIMS team. In other words, we recommend that the team meet at least monthly. However, you may find that your team needs to meet more frequently than monthly. How long should team meetings be? Consider that it typically takes 5 to 10 minutes for a team to discuss one student. Very efficient, experienced teams may be able to spend just 3 or 4 minutes discussing a student. In some cases, the meeting length depends on school schedules and bells. In this instance, the team will need to do the best it can, given these constraints. Remember that how frequently you meet may influence the length of each meeting. What will the EWIMS team in your school or district look like? How will it function? Remember to consider the right people, the right frequency, and the right duration. The questions listed here are important for your team to discuss as you embark on your EWIMS journey. Now, let's talk about two challenges that can be associated with implementing Step 1: insufficient buy-in to the team and messy meetings. We'll also discuss how to address these challenges. The challenge of limited buy-in or support from team members can manifest as canceled meetings, low attendance at meetings, or lack of participation from team members who know students well. Buy-in to the team happens when team members are ready, able, and willing. Consider the following strategies for increasing buy-in. Hold meeting times sacred Refrain from canceling meetings unless absolutely necessary. Set up the expectation that the meetings will be focused on EWIMS. And build a group agreement to prevent unrelated topics from taking over meeting time. Meet consistently. Don't allow too much time to pass in between meetings. Recruit a district champion for the EWIMS process. If your team has someone who knows about the hard work your school is doing for EWIMS, he or she can champion your efforts when competing commitments surface from the district. It's always good to have friends in high places. Make sure that the team meetings are valuable. Preparing thoroughly for team meetings and communicating clearly during and between meetings are good ways to demonstrate that every team member's time is valued. Keep records and show results. A record of when your team met and which students were discussed, along with the team's monitoring notes on intervention plans, is evidence of EWIMS implementation. Demonstrating results can help to address insufficient buy-in from folks who are not part of the effort. The second challenge that may be associated with Step 1 is messy meetings. Messy meetings can include team members using valuable meeting time to relate war stories about their work or their interactions with students, families, or administrators. Team members hijacking meeting time to discuss non-EWIMS issues. Entire team meetings being taken up with discussing one or two students, and inconsistent attendance, different team members showing up at each meeting so that the group's sense of continuity and shared knowledge are diminished. Here are three ways to make your meetings less messy. First, set norms. Sometimes we forget to do this, but in any team, creating norms or ground rules together is helpful. Ask your team what conditions they need to be successful, or what drives them crazy in meetings. Consider the norms listed here. In EWIMS meetings, there is a temptation for team members to focus on the challenges they face with students. These war stories often begin with, "You'll never guess what." One useful norm is, "Agree not to tell war stories." Sometimes educators need to vent to other adults. A best practice for meeting this need is to have a brief check-in at the beginning of each meeting, where team members share a short summary of what's on their mind, so then they can turn their attention to the purpose of the meeting. Another strategy for addressing messy meetings is using time management. Once your team gets into a routine, establish a set amount of time the team will discuss each student. If you exceed that limit, it could be a sign that the student you're discussing needs more intensive interventions. Some teams have a rule that if the discussion of a particular student surpasses 5 minutes, two team members will continue the conversation offline, or the student will be referred to the school social worker. If you agree to use a timer, decide what you will do when the timer goes off. For example, the team might write a referral, extend the timer for 1 minute, or simply move on. Stick to the rules the team has set. Sending out a list of flagged students in advance of a meeting enables team members to think through the observations they will share at the meeting, rather than thinking aloud during the meeting. Be sure to collect updates before team meetings so that you don't waste meeting time looking up information. Designate a team member who will gather information from those who can't attend the meeting and follow up with them afterward to share meeting highlights. Lastly, consider rotating roles. Some teams find that rotating roles encourages buy-in and distributes responsibility across the team. Typical roles include the following: a note taker who uses a holistic approach. Rather than taking meeting minutes, a note taker should focus on capturing information related to who will do what by when. This gives the team a running log of interventions and helps facilitate the monitoring progress. If your data tool has a note-taking section, you can input notes on individual student pages as long as confidentiality is protected. The timekeeper is charged with timing the meeting and discussions about individual students. Using an audible timer can help to keep everyone accountable. The air traffic controller can help to manage meetings that contain many voices and strong feelings. This person's only job in addition to contributing to the conversation, is to pay attention to each team member's airtime. Have fun with this role. The air traffic controller can use a bell or a special hand signal to indicate that a team member's time is up. Knowing that the air traffic controller will call a halt when a team member talks too long can help to build trust and team buy-in. Finally, there's the snack fairy. Who doesn't love a good snack as a reward? Here's a sneak peek for the next video in this series. Step 2 demonstrates how data are uploaded, downloaded, and used in the EWIMS process. The Step 2 video explores using the Michigan Data Hub Early Warning Data Tool. The implementation guide contains information about accessing this tool. If your district is not using this tool, you will need to pull early warning data from your student management system. It may be useful to get support from your intermediate school district with this step. On behalf of the Great Lakes Comprehensive Center, the Michigan Department of Education, and the students and families of Michigan, we thank you for your work on these important issues.